Sanibonani babukeli emakhaya sanamukela ku eMpumalanga. I am TDCB. I am so excited as this is our first episode. Kodwa angihambi ngedwa, ngihamba nesimatsatsa invotsakati hlengiwe.
My goodness, it feels good to be here. I'm gonna take you to church and say gumnanzi kuvela. Teddy, you sure know how to make a sister turn purple. Look at me now, I'm blushing. But anyways, do feel free to join us actually to this show because it's gonna be jam-packed with amazing stuff. From your heritage to the food that we eat to inspirational people who are actually making a mark.
Indeed, uqinisileke sesi wami lana lo muhle uhlengiwe ukuthi le hlelo leli kanifundisa konke lenzinga ngokuthi nikwati ngempumalanga from the turn up places, hotspots, activities, events, you name it. Lagle hlelo lethu sinako.
So if ngabe ungasijoin, then there's something wrong with you ngoba siyokunikeza konke ukhumbule ukuthi siyaqapha ngoba sempumalanga. This is where the sun rises and this is where talent is bred. And before we proceed, it's not busy but overboard because we can talk forever. I mean, our voices are indeed our invoice. So right now let's go to current affairs and check out what's happening in the world.
I'm happy with the 70%. I'm happy that we're still in charge of all our municipalities.
Thank you for joining us on MP News. My name is Lieto Khoza. Mpumalanga Premier David Mabuza has called on the new municipal leadership to humble themselves and become servants of the people. Premier Mabuza was speaking on the 19th of September at the Premier's Coordinating Forum Lekgotla in White River, where he asked especially the executive mayors to passionately and holistically work for the people. He said Mpumalanga province was fortunate that the people still believed in the ruling party, hence it is leading in all municipalities. However, the municipal leadership needed to continue to work hard and win the trust of the people.
Our people have spoken as we're doing door to door. The biggest problem that we face is poverty. Each and every family that I visited, there was no food. And I had to take my 100 rand in my pocket and say, go buy food. Each and every family, household, I experienced poverty.
Mabuza received a report on the 22nd of September of Commission of Inquiry into the Socio-Economic Conditions of Farm Dwellers. The commission was established in September 2015 and was mandated to investigate the report on the socio-economic conditions of farm dwellers in the province. The commission has investigated matters of recommendation on, amongst others, the protection of human rights, safety and security of farm dwellers, security of tenure, employment security, access to equitable and sustainable housing, access to basic services such as water, electricity, sanitation, access to quality education, healthcare, justice, and illegal convictions. The Mpumalanga provincial government is satisfied with the progress of Operation Vuka Sisebente, launched by the Mpumalanga Premier David Mabuza in Bushbuck Ridge in August this year. The Operation Vuka Sisebente has successfully been launched in all the municipalities in Mpumalanga. At least 312 of the 402 war rooms have been established throughout the province. The Operation Vuka Sisebente is an integrated service delivery model that works through multi-sectoral partnerships. It was launched by the provincial government to create vibrant, equitable, and sustainable socio-economic conditions by communities, providing comprehensive, integrated, and transversal service to communities through efficient and effective partnership. The Operation Vuka Sisebente ensures that communities are given support that they need in an integrated and efficient manner by all spheres of government in the province. In our last story, the newly appointed MEC for Human Settlement, Speedy Mashilo, wants to improve service delivery to communities. He met with departmental senior management on the 16th of September to map out a new path in order to expedite service delivery. During his address, Mashilo emphasized the department must strive for an equitable spread of opportunities for all constructors to avoid shoddy workmanship from incapable contractors. Mashilo addressed the managers in a meeting arranged to welcome him in the department following a recent cabinet. He said he needs all those constructors to have the capacity to deliver the services to the people and to make sure that all constructors build houses and infrastructure for the people of Mpumalanga. He further explained that officials should not get confused with what human settlements are, but remember that it entails the building of equitable houses and create habitable infrastructure for the people of Mpumalanga. Thank you for joining us for this edition of the news. We'll see you again next week.
Mbukeli utiveleke nawe etindzaba taseMpumalanga. Mbukeli ngethemba unetisekile ngetindzaba tethu lesingiphathele tona lomuhla. Kodwa manje sothatha likhefu lelincane nje kubara ungawari wena. Siyabuya khona la ekhaya eMpumalanga.
Mbukele siyabonga ukuthi sahleli nathi kulehlelo lethu eMpumalanga. I mean, you could have been anywhere else. Njobe wathi ukuthi eMpumalanga sadiqapha ngebuthini, sadiqapha ngeheritage yethu and culture. But most importantly, I feel we're the number one province that leads in terms of tourism. We've got so many beautiful tourist attraction or establishments, and but one spot that is so amazing. So if you happen to find yourself khona la eMpumalanga, please make a turn at Kasambo Exclusive Guest Lodge. Aga sibone ukuthi bona basiphatheleni.
I'm Elfas Shabangu. I'm the general manager for Kasambo Exclusive Guest Lodge in Mpumalanga. Kasambo is one of the best in Mpumalanga, also in South Africa, because we're having a bigger vision, which we interacting with American people, I can say European people. Also, we're taking our local people very, very seriously because they are our backbone. And then we're having so beautiful houses here. And also the staff, the service, the food is so brilliant. And wherever you come here, you'll love to come back and enjoy this family here of Kasambo. I can say for you traveling all the way from Joburg to Mpumalanga, especially for Kasambo, you will come across the service that we'll give you from the gate, going down to the drink service, the food, the rooming, they are so beautiful. We're having family rooms, we're having honeymoon rooms, which they are so beautiful. Compared to other hotels which are surrounding us here, I can say we're the best so far. We got so many activities that we can give you, which is apart from Joburg, and the tranquility here, it's so beautiful. Okay. Kasambo is the only guest house around in Mpumalanga which is hosting a jam session every month end, which we're having artists like Borei Piri, and then we'll be hosting you, Masigela, and then we also grooming our local artists to be the best as much as they can. And also, the functions that we're having here, we're having the baby showers, we're having the birthday parties, we're having this government corporate businesses, they're coming here. So it means we are at the top of the range and we're doing the best we can do. Sure, we're having our best cocktail in house, which we call Strawberry Daiquiri. It's very, very beautiful, and then it can go so well with any food. It's neutral. Also, we're not forgetting our wine list is a best of range where you can do a pairing maybe with nice steak of meat or T-bone, which is beautiful here. And the chef can play that very, very well, and you love that.
Wow, wake wabona ubuhle lobungaka. Nkosi yami, uhamba imall, ma tavern, all these places kepha awuyati Kasambo, there's definitely something wrong. Angathi kuthi yini Teddy la ngikhombisa yona that will surpass what we've just seen here. I think you can concur kuthi Kasambo Guest Lodge is the one.
Yo, hlengiwe angathi kuthi ngitsini tindzawo dihle kakhulu leyo tihamba ko lapho sifise futhi sibonge yona iKasambo futhi usinika leli fuba lokuthi sirecorde sishuthe la emagcekeni awo lelo hlelo lesimphathela lona lo muhla. Kodwa ke mbukeli uyathi nawe ukuthi iMpumalanga neSouth Africa yonke igcwele ngeheritage and culture. So manje ake sive ke kuwapthwala ukuthi yena osiphatheleni kumagugu.
Ngibonga kakhulu bantfu abami ngalokho ukuthi sibe nalesikhashana lesincane sekubonisana nangokuthi nathi emagugu abaluleka kanganani ayini empilweni yabantu. Nasikhuluma ngemagugu ngiloku lesithi heritage. Emagugu ngiloku angiloku lesingiko. Emagugu ethu nelusiko lwethu kwakhelwe etukwemlando wethu, ihistory, umlando. ngikho nje utawukhanza ukuthi bani bathi akwendiwa kanje ngesikithi ngoba bayalo sibaqhamuka kuphi kepha abantu labangathi sibaqhamuka kuphi bavame lokuthi bangathi uthi ngikuphi lokubakhokhelako so umlando ngalamafisha ngiyo lo sita ukuthi wende umuntu athi uthi uqhamuka kuphi ngoba ube sowugubha lokulugugu ngesikenu kepha leli gugu kuba likhulu lokuthi utawugubha emagugu ungalathi limi lakenu ngoba kufuthi osilosi usathi lesiswati wada nokuthi nawende ugubha emagugu imvunulo embathwa njani ivunulwa njani sikhanza emadorobheni nje kakhulu khanze emajaha bavunule emahiya kepha bangakacethi ngoba emajoba awekho bese siyamangala ukuthi ngabe lo vunile esiphi ngoba ungumfati noma ngabe indvodza ngapha nawe indvodza kufanele ube nelijobo ngetulo emagugu abalekile bekunene ngoba ngiwo lawa lenta ukuthi sisive sisahle sisitathu sibobani sichamuka kuphi bese enda lokhu kwentelwani ngiwo ke hulumende asasitileke nyalo ngokuthi agucule indlela yakubusa asivumele ukuthi nathi sibe nekwethu kubuhlunge lokuthi bese bakhwa letinye TV letithi lelilanga lemagugu lelibekwe nguhulumende bese balibeda ngelilama yobraya akusiko lokho ngegugu ethu bafuna ukusibhimbisa thine kufuna sihambe kuloku lekulugugu ngesikethu lokulugugu ngesikethu kulokuvuselela nalapho sichamuka khona ekudleni imvunulo nekusina kubalulekile ukuthi sivele sisha sivikeleke sivele sisha asinawo divikela sona sivikela abatali nembuti nenkomo nayo engeluswa iyalahleka kumbe ifohle nebantu babethu bayafuna lo sisibeluse singebatali babo labantu babethu bayalalela nkosi yami bayeva nawo batshela kufana nje labantu labadzala ngibo lasebancena lokuthi babafundise babakhuthate ngebuve babo ngoba sekubona shanga setilimit angesheya bosingisi ngito letingcono ekubeni lesikethu ngiso lesingiso ngoba simaswati sibantu sama-Afrika ngato tilimit ethu nemagugu ethu bani lebasha bafanele ukuthi bavikeleke ngekuthi bagcukutele ukuthi bafunze ukukhuluma kwasekhaya bayathi inkulumo yasekhaya bathi ukudla kwasekhaya bathi nemvunulo nenokuthi umntwana lomncane utiphatha kanjani nawe ingabisa kumbe elijaha utiphatha njani ukhuluma njani nabantu labadzala konke lokho ukuthi awumsitha usilowo mntwana lona kakhulu abe ngumuntu kusasa akwadi ukuthinta kungemagugu akubo uhamba kuphi nakuthiwa kukhuluma siswati mina kethu khuluma thathe wethu ube ukhuluma lokungikho asibonge bekunene nasithi kusile bekunene.
Siyabonga kakhulu kuwe ke babuthwala ngokusifundzisa ukuthi bunvu kumele sikugcine and bunvu ngiko lokutasenda siphumelele empilweni kanye nakhona la emhlabeni mbukeli ngaphambi kokuthi ngichithe isikhathi athi sihambe siyonathe mandi.
Sabonga ukuthi sahleli nathi khona la eMpumalanga. Something amazing happened. Teddy got invited to an event that took place by a big fish, Mr. Sipho Makabane himself. So what he did is he took to the streets to scout for talent that was going to be part of a choir yakhe called Mpumalanga Praise. Uvele waya emakhaya wathi yatini, Mpumalanga inel talent. Why not inhlanganise bantwana sakhe i choir, sende a live CD and DVD recording. Teddy went to church on the hill Gamakuku to cover everything that took place. My goodness, I'm so jealous because I was left behind, but it's okay. No sweat, he's part of the team, so it's cool. Let's see what's going to interview about because I'm so excited. There were so many artists. Why didn't you go with me, T?
Ngiyabonga kakhulu sisi wami Hlengiwe hey kodwa wena namuhla uphutselwe ke uphutselwe I can't wait we are at the Mpumalanga first ever Mpumalanga Praise CD and live DVD recording angathi ukuthi intive nginjani kodwa nje ngitfukile ngijabulile all at the same time siyongena manje to see and witness everything that's happening inside and also I'm going to get a chance to khulumisa now to tatanyiswa tethu tanamuhla your celebrities your personalities artists and everyone who's performing and hey I hope I'm going to get a chance yokubona ngemuva the backstage asiyeni khona right now I'm standing with Mam Sibongile Nkosi spokesperson of the department Department of Culture, Sport and Recreation. Mam Sibongile, this is an amazing establishment. Mpumalanga Praise, first live CD and DVD recording. What would you like to say to the young talent on stage and everybody who came here to support tonight?
As a Department of Culture, Sports and Recreation under the Mpumalanga Provincial Government, we are actually excited about this. This is the first of its kind. It shows that in Mpumalanga we do have talent. And Babu Sipho Makhabane, we appreciate him, we praise him, because he was able to come to our department and say, please, can you assist? Now, as a department that is responsible and that has a mandate of developing talent, we felt this is a very good platform for us to unearth the talent from all the regions in Mpumalanga. As you can see the choir there, it's all the regions that we have, and it shows that we have talent. You'll recall that last year in the Clash of the Choirs, yes, we were number one, and we've got our own Karabo, who is Idols. We've got Musa, who also won the Idols in 2014. So Mpumalanga has a talent, and we are very, very excited about it.
Thank you very much, Ma. What an amazing, amazing, amazing establishment this is. Siyabonga kakhulu to you and also the department.
Thank you very much.
Sisongwane, you are an artist hailing from KZN. And tonight you are here, you traveled all the way to perform here in Mpumalanga with Mpumalanga Praise. How has the experience been for you?
First of all, thank you so much for the opportunity. Let me start by greeting all the viewers at home. Sanbonani. For me, it's a great honor, like to perform to different provinces, especially in Nelspruit. I know abantu base Nelspruit, they love music engwenzayo kakhulu, and I really appreciate that. And also to be a part of this wonderful thing that is happening today, because we all know Gucci, there is a new group that is recording the DVD, and I always want to support whatever that is coming in the music industry, because we need a fresh talent as well. So I'm so happy Gucci Lana, and also I'll be performing some of my new songs from my new album. I'm so happy about that, and I don't know how to explain indlela feel ngayo nje, kodwa ngijabule kakhulu.
Amen. We salute each and everyone who has worked in this project.
Thank you.
Mpumalanga Praise, first ever live CD and DVD recording. Nyaloke ngime nayo inzandvo gati yasempumalanga kanyamazane khona la embombela phindile phoku. You are a member of a joyous celebration.
Yeah.
Kodwa uyibone kukuhle ukuthi ubuye ekhaya uthathe bantwana labakhutsele labona likhono lomculo waba groomer nenda into lehle lefana nanaye recording. Utiva njani?
Yo, ngitiva ngijabule kakhulu ngoba ngisi sikhathi awucabanga ukuthi mhlambe ungahle ufike la kulezi zinga lenkulu mina bengingacabanga, uyabona, but ngijabule kakhulu, ngijabule kakhulu. I'm proud of myself. Yeah.
So uthandza kutsini kubo bonke labantwana lo sembene nabo, even nalabo abatile kuma audition who didn't make it, uthandza kutsini kuba khutsata nje?
Kakhulu kade kulaba bangakaphumeleli kule khwaya ukuthi bangene. Ngifuna abathi ukuthi abasithi hluleki. Bekunento letsite bekayifuna kababa Makhabane uyitholile, hayi ukuthi bathi hluleki, abachubeke lephambili bangayekeli. Yeah.
You've got your new album manje isiphumile ikhona etitolo, sishele kabandi ngayo.
Yeah. Oh, ngijabule kakhulu ngealbum yami. Sihloko sayo ithi Jesu usihola kahle endleleni. Meaning ukuthi mangichecka impilo yami from ebuqaneni ngize ngifike la ngikhona khona, ungihole kahle noma bekuba nebumatima lobukhona endleleni, but ungihole kahle. Yeah.
And indeed utasihola nanamuhla babukeli, that was Phindile Phoku. Sisekhona lana, let's check out more. Sisekhona lana kuMpumalanga Praise, first ever CD and DVD recording. Nyalo ngime nenzandvukati yeSouth Africa jikelele yonke uMama Mhlengiwe Mhlaba. Mama, you hail from KZN, kodwa today you took part in the Mpumalanga Praise DVD recording. How has the experience been for you being here and performing here?
Number one, ngiyayithanda kakhulu, ngibingelela ababukela emakhaya. Ngiyayithanda kakhulu iMpumalanga Province because umuntu ongizalayo kule industry yaka music owala eMpumalanga uSipho Makhabane, and also umuntu ozene eMpumalanga Praise kusawuyena futhi udedi engibiza ngodedi ke mina ukuthi ayiqale le concept and I believe iMpumalanga is going to benefit especially abantu abasha kule concept yabo and then engizocela nje kukho is that music it's a gift but the character will keep them not only the gift
amen kwangathi uNkulunkulu angasisida njengoba lilanga liphumela ngathi nathi sikhona kuphuma thank you very much mam hlengi ngomhlaba
thank you so much ngiyabonga kakhulu
babukeli sifikile sibonile sibusisekile kakhulu ngiyethemba ukuthi nawe lapho ukhona ubusikile njengoba nathi lana sibusisekile sibabonile ke bonke the MP praise and everyone lobe kacula khona namuhla sibafisela inhlanhla all the best to you hlengiwe asive
And Bonin and Gutsi, the event was lit. As young people would say, Gutsi, no, it was epic. But one song that stood out for me was from an artist while I'm Mpumalanga. Uyasho man, uthi ngizohlala ezinyaweni zika Jehova. My goodness, take me to church, somebody. Hallelujah. But anyways, right now we're moving to a segment called Mpumalanga's Greatest. Right now we are celebrating a heroine. Right now we are celebrating a force to be reckoned with. I consider her as an amazing broadcaster. She is a businesswoman, Carol Sanderson, Mrs. Carol Sanderson. My goodness, angikuthi ngaqala kuthini? She's also my mentor. Ngiqala ukuthi sive ukuthi kahle kahle wena ungafunda ini kuye because trust me, you really need to hear this woman speak.
She's an entrepreneur, she's a business person, a very loving, outgoing person according to them. I'm always surrounded by people and I spread the love all the time. And I'm a person that basically a whole lot of people turn to look up to. Yo, my favorite childhood memories would be with my late brother. We grew up together. We were more like twins because we were just a year apart. And my mother left us. Actually, we were staying with my mother. I think my parents just broke up and we had to stay with our mother and she too did not stay for long. She decided to just leave us out of the blue without saying a word. So it was just me and my brother. We actually grew up as parents to our two siblings. So he was taking more of the fatherhood and I'll be more of the mother because he was always responsible for what we have to eat. And I have to be responsible for cooking whatever that he brings home. So my childhood memories would be with me and him sitting around the fire, cooking whatever that is, whether it can be gusha or anything else. But we'll be talking about life. We will be talking about things that we would love to have when you grow up. We'll be talking about how we're going to find our mother. And he was always just looking after me. And I miss him so much. Well, obviously, it's Kasambo. I love this place so much because when we bought it, it was a family home. We bought it for us. We bought it for ourselves, for our kids. And we'll walk around with my husband every day when I knock off from work. And we'll just admire the nature, the landscape, the beauty of this place. And I just can't get enough of it every day. So that's why we then decided, let's share it with the world out there. And let's build something that's going to bring people to come in and see the beauty that we've got in this little piece of land. My greatest business achievement was when Tsoho-san actually walked to these premises. MTPA brought Tsoho-san here because they were looking for entrepreneurs that they could be able to groom. So at that time, I was fresh from journalism. I knew nothing about the hospitality industry, but I knew what it is that I wanted out of this space. So when they got here, I was actually in between spaces whereby I was thinking whether I should register some business management studies something that was going to groom me in terms of how to manage business because my husband is the one that knows the house in terms of the business as an entrepreneur. So I needed to build myself up. And when Soweto-san walked here, they identified me as one of the entrepreneurs that would love to groom. And that is when, you know, all came together. I always tell myself that whatever got me here is not going to get me there. It's very important to work on yourself in terms of whatever space you find yourself in. So you can't say that you are used to eating lobsters and whatever that you can be able to afford. And then you get to a space whereby all of that just falls apart and you cannot be able to cope. You have to cope and you have to lift yourself up. You have to dust yourself off and you have to move on. Stand up, rise above everything and do it for yourself. Whoever is going to try and hold your hand or whoever is going to find you out there, they'll find you on your way to your destination. I mean, when I started working, I had nowhere to go after matric. I had already had two kids and it was very difficult even growing up. So all the negative things, I felt as if it was just coming to me all the time. And my family left, my mother left. But you can't then just hold on to that and say you are just a nobody and you don't know how to do things for yourself. You are an able child and you have to stand up and rise above everything else. So I started listening to this radio station and I started analyzing each and every voice that I heard on the radio station. I started seeing myself there. I started visualizing myself there. I started seeing myself reading news there. And I started doing it. I would take old newspapers. I would write my own little stories. I'll stand in front of the mirror. I would practice and I'll be talking and I'll be practicing and I'll do interviews on my own. By the time I went and I applied at that radio station, I was already a polished product. And they had nothing to offer for me. I volunteered, but I did everything. Music is my soul. It fills me up and it keeps me moving. Motherhood is everything to me because it's like sharing everything that I have with my kids, including the love, and they give it back to me. And that's what keeps me whole. Radio is my life. Once the bug bites you, I don't think there's any cure. Love is when you decide to give yourself unconditionally to an imperfect person and you build life with them. Mpumalanga is the place of the rising sun, and that's where we're rising, and we're rising every day.
It's been an amazing show. Mpumalanga, we finished it. Hlengiwe, how do you rate me?
Well, let's give the pause to the viewers. You have a hashtag Mpumalanga on Twitter. Trust me, Twitter tweeps are not friendly. If you're good, you're good. If you went, you went. But I feel good we did well.
Epic is the word, right?
15 over 10 when I bad. Standard.
If I was very close, I'd say high five. But hey, Bluetooth.
Infrared.
Awesome stuff. Now do catch us on our social media platforms, Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. Teddy Sandile Sibiya on Facebook and Teddy Sibiya on Instagram, also Twitter.
And of course you can catch me on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, on Twitter H_Sindane, that is S-I-N-D-A-N-E, on Instagram Miss.Sindane, and on Facebook Hlengiwe Amanda H.
And we are signing out. Don't forget, I am Teddy Sibiya
and I am Hlengiwe Sindane. Teddy and I Audi. Oh.